are you doing there?
Right. You're waiting for a YouTube video, right? Okay. It's been a long time, but I'm back. So let's dive right into something cool today. Join me.
So today's video is going to be a follow-up on my K-swapped MR2. So there has been quite a lot of things happening recently, and it was just a little bit behind the scenes because I've been really taken up by other projects such as the hill climb car, as well as just business and racing and family, etc. So let me walk you through a few things that happened on the MR2, and I hope you like Dyno videos because that's what you're gonna get today. So without further ado, join me and let's dive right into it. So we're back on the MR2. As you know, I built an MR2 with a 2ZZ, then broke the engine and decided that the year after that I would case swap it. This has been already a year or so ago. The swap has gone really well, and now this video is going to show you what happened on the dyno, since that was the last thing that I had to do in order to get the car ready for doing some driving with it. The dyno tuning has been done by my friend Mike. He is probably one of the best mappers and tuners I know, so big shout out to Mike. This time I actually, since he was here and doing some work for me, I asked him, do you want to tune my car? And he said yes, so I let him go at it. He's probably the only guy I would trust to actually let somebody tune my car. So let's take a look at what he managed to do. It's always nice to see a K20 engine screaming as loud as it can, and on the dyno. And it's always funny because I love showing this experience to my customers also when they have their car on the dyno, because they can actually see how their car is giving its all right in front of them and they're not sitting in the car. So it's pretty funny to see their reactions. Anyhow, you can see that the car is very healthy. I actually have the dyno graphs that I'm going to put on the screen now. And as you can see, the car made 222 or 223 horsepower for 223 Newton meters. So the car is running really healthily. I've had other K20s on my dyno, similar configurations, and this one actually made a little bit more than the other ones. I'm pretty sure we could play with when the VTEC comes on or the VTEC cam degrees and probably squeeze out a little bit more. But to be honest, I'm already very happy with that horsepower, given the fact that the stock K20 on my dyno actually makes 180 horsepower, roughly. So that shows really that the car is healthy and running well. There's a massive 40 horsepower increase, which is really cool. And you will see, I'll be making another video really soon comparing all the different configurations that my car had with dyno graphs and show what is the best configuration for the MR2. And you guys can tell me after in the comments what you think. Important note to make though is, as you can see on the graph, I put 18% transmission loss. That is something that is very individual to my way of calculating on my dyno. I've done almost all my cars with 18%, so that's just a figure I've been sticking to. But I'd say probably on the FRS GT86 BRZ platform, that is a very close number to reality. Whereas, as you know, it's also a hub dyno, my dyno, so it's not a roller dyno, so it's a totally different ballgame. But there are other people with dyna packs like I do. They put 20 or 25% because one would say front wheel drive, or since the MR2 is a front wheel drive built up in the wrong direction, basically, there is possibility that there's actually more transmission loss than just 18%. So if we would take the 223 horsepower and divide it by 1.18, that would give us roughly 188 horsepower at the hubs. And if we multiply it by, for example, let's say 25, so 25% transmission loss, I'd be already at 236 horsepower. So as you can see, one has to always take the dyno graphs and the dyno data with a pinch of salt, because it always can be played with. My dyno, of course, you cannot play with the strap tension or how strongly you strap the car onto the dyno. That doesn't work. You're not gonna change the power by changing the how tightly you tighten the hubs on the car. But on the other hand, you can sort of determine what is a fit transmission loss for your application, and that's where people can cheat you. So just be aware that the TCF factor that you see, the TC factor, TCF 1.18, means there is a transmission loss of 18%. So I hope this video was interesting for you. I'm looking forward to showing you the next one, because to be honest, one of my best videos that has been creating the most reactions and the most views is actually, you can see it up here, is my comparison between K20 and 2ZZ. And now I'm gonna be doing episode 2. So make sure to subscribe and like this video. And the next video of the MR2 is gonna be on a racetrack, where I will be comparing it to my old setup and see if I've gained anything. I don't know why, but I don't have such a good feeling about that. Anyway, thank you so much for watching the video until now. I look forward to seeing you soon in the next video. And without further ado, take care and see you next week. Peace.